Hello, my dear friends. How are you? Myself is Professor Dr. Rajendra Deshpande, and we have started about the medicine in general medical practice series, and we are started with the digestive tract problems in general practice. Myself, Professor Dr. Deshpande, MD in Ayurvedic medicine and MD in Ayurvedic physiology. So my WhatsApp number is 922-6810-630. Let us start one presentation after another. So here we can see the digestive system problems are like anorexia, indigestion, aerophagy or the gas problem, then stomatitis problem, hiccup problem, constipation and diarrhea. Then there may be vomiting, dysphagia, difficulty in deglutition, pain in abdomen, IBS, jaundice and peptic ulcer. We will start today about the vomiting problem. So vomiting is very irritating problem and makes it troublesome. If at all it is not controlled immediately or diagnosed properly, it can have a serious consequences like dehydration. And it may be the dehydration, what you can say, the grade 1, grade 2 or grade 3. If the dehydration goes up to the stage of grade 3 without proper management, then the patient may die. So quite important this particular symptom is, that is vomiting. So we will talk today about nausea and vomiting causes. Why I am always insisting about the causes? My dear friends, try to understand. Whether you practice allopathy, whether you practice Ayurveda, whether you practice homeopathy, whether you practice naturopathy or even sympathy. But the most important thing, your proper diagnosis of the cause is very important. Because Ayurveda also says that what is the first step of the treatment? That step is Sankshepataha Kriyayogo Nidana Parivarjanam. Sankshepataha Kriyayogo Nidana Parivarjanam. Sankshepataha means in short. Kriyayogo means management. Nidana means etiology or causes. And Parivarjana to stop, to control, to make rid of that particular causes or etiological factors. So what are the causes of nausea and vomiting? Number one, inflammation of the stomach, which is called as a gastritis. In Ayurveda, it can be compared with amla pitta. Then there are problems like peptic ulcer, it may be gastric ulcer or it may be duodenal ulcer, which can be called in Ayurveda as a parinama shula. Shula is a pain, abdominal pain. In the female patient, in the early periods, first 2-3 months, the pregnancy, there is amenorrhea as well as nausea and vomiting. Morning sickness is there. Then some medicines like aspirin, then NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Here, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Of course, the many patients take it by themselves for the problems of arthralgia, backache, headache. Then this is particular medicine Flagyl, which is related with anti-amoebic. Nowadays we less use this metronidazole, we use the tinidazole. But chloroquine was a very famous or is famous medicine to treat the malarial fever. So these particular NSAIDs or this type of their medicines as well as alcohol consumption is a cause of vomiting. Then there is one serious part, that is vomiting with abdominal distension and colicky pain. My dear friends, don't miss this particular diagnosis because it suggests intestinal obstruction and this is emergency. Try to understand. There are two types of the, what you can say, the urgency and emergency words. Urgency is the word related with the problems, health problems. It may be the colicky pain. That means urgent medicines, urgent injectables, IVs are required. But that urgency doesn't cause any fatal consequences. But when you talk about emergency, emergency patients is a having last fatal, what you can say, the outcome. And so in emergency, the patient should be admitted in the hospital. So this particular condition, fourth condition, is definitely very serious condition. Then vomitus with patient having the breath of kerosene or organophosphorus poisoning like TIC-20. So this particular poisoning cases also has the main complaint as a vomiting. Then vomiting with headache and high fever, this is also I can say the emergency. The patient, these all 5 and 6, these are emergency managements. We have to rush to the hospital and treat intravenous fluids and ICU management. So meningitis is the inflammation of meninges, very serious problem or very serious cause regarding the vomiting. We should not miss that. I think high fever, headache is there, but I remember Babinski's sign, that means the plantar reflex, is very much important in the cases of diagnosing meningitis. Then simple urgency, I can say, in our general medical practice, GP, vomiting with loose motion is very, very common, which we call it as a gastroenteritis, is again poisoning, food poisoning, inflammation of the stomach as well as inflammation of the intestine. Short form is gastroenteritis, inflammation of stomach and intestine. Then, what is there? Vomiting with right hypochondriac pain, vomiting with the upper part of your abdomen. Remember, above the umbilicus on the right side, there is a place of liver, and so inflammation of the liver or inflammation of the gallbladder, inflammation of the liver is hepatitis, inflammation of the gallbladder is cholecystitis. So both these conditions can cause vomiting. If you go down little bit on the lower abdomen, then vomiting with pain in the right iliac fossa is because of the acute appendicitis. Then, this is of course the emergency, I can say. Vomiting and pain in the loin region is because of the kidney problem, acute pyelonephritis. Let us go further. Then vomiting with severe peripheral vertigo, it can be because of the Meniere's disease or vestibular neuritis. So problem is in the middle and the inner ear. Then another serious problem is vomiting with uncontrolled diabetes mellitus. The patient is not taking regular insulin or the tablets, he is not following the do's and don'ts, he is eating a lot of sugar substances, his glycosylated hemoglobin is nearly about 10, that means average of the last 3 months, and of course the patient then lands into the ketoacidosis. Lot of ketone bodies are developed in the uncontrolled diabetes. The blood sugar you can see by glucometer near about 800 or 1000 milligram per 100 ml. And another idiopathic type of cause is the cyclical vomiting. That means all above 12 causes you remove and nothing has been found out, then that can be called as a cyclical vomiting or idiopathic vomiting. So this all the description has been written in a very neat and tabular form. So one part is associated symptoms and another part is of diagnosis. So vomiting with loose motion is causes of course gastroenteritis because of the food poisoning in epidemics in the rainy season especially. Vomiting with severe headache and high fever, of course these are the symptoms. Babinski's sign is a sign. It gives the idea about meningitis and encephalitis. Then vomiting, again this main symptom, with the heartburn. There is a burning in the chest region, stomach burn. This may be because of the inflammation of the stomach, that is acute gastritis, alcohol abused in large quantity, or because of the overdose of non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Vomiting in elderly patient with sweating, very serious. Remember, the patient is around about 40, 50, 60, and all of a sudden he start vomiting with sweating all over the body, profuse sweating I can say. This is because of the acute myocardial infarction, and if you don't treat it, it's very serious. So call the ambulance 108 in Maharashtra state of India. This is very good to take the patient to the ICU or CCU. Then vomiting with the history of amenorrhea in the ladies It may be indicating hyperemesis gravidarum, that means the pregnancy vomiting in the first 2-3 months. Vomiting in the right hypochondriac region suggests the inflammation of the liver hepatitis or inflammation of the gallbladder, that is cholecystitis. Vomiting in plus pain in the right iliac fossa, it may suggest you acute attack of appendicitis, inflammation of the appendix. Vomiting with pain in the loin suggests you the kidney problem, that is pyelonephritis, and may be due to the renal calculus. Vomiting with serious abdominal rigidity, board-like rigidity, remember my words, very hard, very tough, board-like rigidity suggests very serious problem like intestinal obstruction. The patient, it also called as a surgical abdomen. That means more or times surgical intervention is needed. That's why it is called as a surgical abdomen. Vomiting with vertigo and tinnitus, it suggests the ear problem like Meniere's disease and vestibular neuronitis. Vomiting with uncontrolled diabetes mellitus, it may suggest you the unconsciousness, diabetic ketoacidosis, ketone bodies are there. And vomiting without any specific symptom, rather very specific, I can not symptom, but without any accompanying symptoms or disease, but occur periodically, it can be labeled as a cyclical vomiting or idiopathic vomiting. Now, first part you should remember that we have to rule out the causative factors, treat the original cause like, for example, if it is a cause like appendicitis or cholecystitis, then you have to treat accordingly with antibiotics and all these things. But symptomatically, what you can do, injection Reglan or injection Perinorm, spelling is wrong, it should be NORM, there is no U, injection Perinorm, 10 milligrams stat. There are little bit side effects you should keep into the mind, in the doctor's mind. Then these extra pyramidal symptoms occur, then you can use the injection Compose as an antidote, 1 cc IV or intramuscular. In the pregnancy, in spite of this medicine, you have to prescribe tablet pregnidoxin, 12.5 mg 3 times in a day. Pregnidoxin is a brand name which contains meclizine hydrochloride. If there is a severe vomiting, that means the patient cannot consume this internal medicine by oral medicine, or severe dehydration is there, then another latest generation anti-emetic drugs like tablet or injection ondansetron, MSET, ondansetron, 4 mg intramuscular stat you have to give. In addition to that, to control the dehydration, you can give the DNS and Ringer lactate. In Ayurveda, this vomiting is called as a chardi. Remember the word chardi. And Ayurveda also has some symptomatic management, like we have the tablet Vomitabe from Charak Pharmaceuticals, this Vomitabe tablet or syrup. In the children you can give the syrup, in the adult you can give the tablet, one tablet 3 times in a day, or there is a one powder which is called as the Mayura Pichha Mashi, 250 mg with honey 3 times in a day as a licking material. Then in spite of Vomitabe, you can use this combination, Laghu Sutta Shekhara tablet, 2 tablets 3 times in a day, Pravala Pishti Vati, this is typical antacid, 2 TDS, and Kama Dudha tablet, 1 TDS. So these are all Ayurvedic medicines, Laghu Sutta Shekhara, Pravala Pishti Vati, and here also the spelling mistake is there, this is a Vati, Pravala Pishti Vati. Vati is a tablet, two tablets morning, 2 tablets afternoon, 2 tablets in the evening, then Kama Dudha tablet, 1 TDS. So my dear friends, in this particular our video, we have tried to understand the important digestive problem, that is vomiting, the causes and the symptomatic management. I hope you have liked my particular video, and you are all requested to subscribe my this particular YouTube channel. Next time we will start this problem, that is flatulence or gas or the belching. Till then, I wish all the best. Please take care. And don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.